Hi everyone, my name is Bandeep, and in today's video, we are going to discuss about the logistic regression. So how logistic regression works conceptually, I covered that part in previous video. Just a reminder, logistic regression is used in cases where as it we want to classify our data into different category, or we have some that sort of data set or that sort of requirement, whereas in we want to predict based on some classification. For example, let's say you are given three or four type of different flowers, and for each flower you are given some attribute of each flower. Let's say the petal width of that particular type of flower is this 1 centimeter, this is the sepal length. So based on those, let's say if we want to classify that, okay, this flower belongs to A category, B category, or C category, whatever. So in those type of cases, we use multi-class logistic regression. Logistic regression is like basically of either binary classification, whereas in we just divide into two classes, and multi-class means when we have to kind of classify our data into more than two categories. So another example in this case could be like email is a spam or not. So in such scenarios, we can use multiple, binary logistic regression, whereas in our target is of either it is a spam or it is not a spam. So in today's, for today's Python code, we are going to use Iris dataset. Iris dataset is with the sklearn library. You go to the sklearn library and you can download from here. And this data, what this data tells you about. So basically you are given some features about a particular type of flower, and you need to predict what kind of flower it is. So here, these are the features which are given: sepal length, sepal width, petal length, petal width. And based on these features, this flower could be out of these three categories: setosa, veris color, and virginica. So this is our data set. And since this data set is with sklearn library, so this data is very clean. So we do not need to do two steps. One is exploratory data analysis. The second one is feature engineering. So we can directly use this data set. We can create our model, train our model, and then predict. So now let's move on to the code part. Very first thing, I am just importing those libraries which are generally required. And here I am loading my Iris dataset from sklearn library. You can see from sklearn import datasets. Then from dataset, I am calling this load iris method. And then it is giving me the iris. I am assigning that into iris object. When you will do dir of iris, it will give you all of the details or the columns about this particular data. This is DSCR is description. This is data. These are the feature name. This is the file name. This is the frame, target, and target name. So our target names, are this one, because we need to find target names are the type of flower which we want to predict. And if we iris.target will give the target value in a numerical form. For example, let's say for a particular setosa type of flower, now this has been converted into numerical form. How it has been converted into numerical form, for this point of time, we can ignore that part. We can assume that there is an image, and that image has been converted into somehow with some mechanism into numerical form. And those numerical values or those metrics is available into this our iris.target, right? So next, as I told you, iris.featuresName will give me the features which we are going to use to predict. iris.data will give me the data frame kind of thing. Like this is my sepal length, this is my sepal width, petal length, or petal width. So this is very quick. And Now, since we do not need to do all these exploratory data analysis and feature engineering, we are just directly jumping on creating the logistic regression model. How we can do this? From SQL learn.linear model, we can import logistic regression class, create an object of it, logistic regression, and then assign it to some variable. Here I have assigned using name as model. And then I'm just regular practice, I'm just splitting my data set into two subsets. One is a training data set, and the other one is the test data set. Test data set is a kind of sample which we always keep for the testing purpose of our model. So in that, what we do is like we keep out some data, and we give that data during our testing phase so that our model get to predict for the values which are never seen earlier before by our model. So this is how we can do this. From SQL Learn library, from model selection, we import train test split class. We then create an object of it. We pass the X variable and Y variable. X variable is our iris data, and Y variable is our target variable. And then we specify the test size. 0.2 means 20% of the data we want to keep as test data. Then it will subsequently will give me kind of data frames, X train, X test, Y train, Y test. Then using model.fit, I'm going to train my model on this data set using X train and Y train. After that, I'm going to use my model.predict, which I'm going to use X test data set, and I'm using that into assigning those predicted value into Y predict. After this, now my model has been trained, and my model has predicted some values for the given test data set. And now I want to check the accuracy, how my model is doing. So for that, we have from SQL Learn.matrices, we have R2Score. R2Score is used to classify, in case of generally where we have to do classification, in that we pass the Y test and Y predicted. Y test is the actual values of Y variable, and Y predicted is the values which are predicted by our model for our target variable. So it compares like how many values are matching with each other, then it gives us the score. So here it is giving me 0.95. That means 95% of the values are matching in this case. So that's how multiple logistic regression works, or binary logistic regression works. So guys, one key takeaway from here is that this was quick. The second was like reason it was quick, because we have very clean data set, which is generally do not happen into real world. But just for the sake of understanding how it works, I took the iris data set. It is available with the SQL Learn library. You can do your hands dirty with it, and you can try it out. And the third one is like how binary logistic regression and multi class logistic regression differs. So all of these things have been covered into this video. And so that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. And in last, as every YouTuber say, I also do. So if you like whatever I'm creating, then please like, subscribe my channel. It will be really helpful for me, because creating YouTube video is also not easy. It takes a lot of efforts. So again, thank you guys. See you. Bye.